You have team clothes. The average American spends almost $2,000 a year on clothing, and 3.3 million tons of textiles end up in our landfills in the same amount of time. What's left in your closet, though, about 50% of it goes unworn. People constantly try to hop on trends that are set by fast fashion. However, there are 11 to 52 micro-seasons in a fast fashion year, and micro-seasons are the seasons between fall, winter, spring, summer that were only created so that companies can get more of their money. Companies like Forever 21 and H&M don't care about the environment, no matter how much they try to greenwash their brands. They just want as much of your money as possible. However, there is a solution. Capsule wardrobes. It's a collection of a few essential items that don't go out of style, and pieces that are linked to the current or upcoming season. It saves you money since you aren't going out shopping all the time. And you love every item, so you'll be wearing everything in your closet, which creates less waste. It'll also save you time, because everything goes together. You can pick something off the rack, and you know it'll look good. And finally, it limits decision fatigue, which is the difficulty of making good decisions after using a lot of your brain power beforehand. And if for some reason you need an even better reason, I get to logistically pummel capitalism's posterior. I'm Nick Robinson, and I made a capsule wardrobe. Here's how.
The first thing you're going to do is pick the pieces that are going to go in your wardrobe. And to do that, you need an aesthetic. The easiest way to do this is to begin looking at your favorite fashion pages. Not only should you like the clothing they're wearing, but you should be willing to wear that outfit or something very similar yourself. You need to keep in mind your body type compared to theirs, because some things don't look the same on different body types. You also need to think about how confident and outgoing you are when it comes to fashion, because if you're not confident in an outfit, it won't look good. You can wear the same outfit when you're confident and when you're not, and it'll look a lot better when you are. Next, you need to go through what's in your closet and figure out what fits that style. You shouldn't have to buy new clothing, because the point of this is to save you money and to keep you from buying new things that you don't need. However, if you must, it should be a last resort, but I'm sure you have something. If you're curious about my aesthetic, click the iCard and it'll take you to a video all about it. Next, you need to make a limit for how many items you're gonna have in your closet. For me, I said no greater than 40. And considering I have about 40 pieces in my closet now, I probably had somewhere close to 100 pieces back before I started separating clothes to donate. Next, you need to go through each piece in your closet and make note of what you're keeping. My list, that way I'm able to remember. And if I'm unsure, I can just refer back to it. Be sure to keep in mind the upcoming season, your body type, and your clothes size. As much as I hate to say it, not every single outfit is made for you. Just because something comes in your size doesn't mean you should wear it. For example, I look good in high-waisted jeans, but if you have a really short torso, you're not gonna look the same. If you're trying to change the way you look, don't keep some form of motivational item in your closet. It's honestly just gonna make you look guilty. It'll be another thing that you don't wear, and seeing it's gonna make you upset. Next, you need to take out everything in your closet, and I mean every single item. Because if you leave everything in your closet, you're a lot more likely to keep more things. So by taking them out of your closet, you're more likely to take things out of your wardrobe. When you're going through everything, only keep what's on your list. Because you're trying to turn your wardrobe into something that is functional, not something that's full of your sentimental pieces. You may want them, you may not. Personally, I don't really care. And I kept a few of them because I feel weird getting rid of them. However, they're away from my main wardrobe. This is the part that needs some serious self-control. Because as humans, we know we bought the pieces, we know we spent money on it, we don't want to waste our money by not wearing the clothes. You've already wasted your money, just get rid of it. Now you're gonna need to box up the unwanted items. You can either donate them, sell them, or gift them to someone. You can donate clothes to Goodwill, Salvation Army, Second Avenue, and shelters. So if you're interested in selling, I suggest things like Poshmark, ThredUp, and Depop. Also, eBay and Etsy. You could just give your clothes to a friend or family member that you think either needs or wants them. There are probably some things in your closet that you think you do want to keep, but they don't really match the current season, and you should be able to box those up too. As long as they match whatever style you're going for, put them in a box and keep them away from your current wardrobe, since capsule wardrobes tend to focus on the current season. Put my stuff in a roller box that went under my bed, and also the drawers in my closet, and I hung up some stuff that couldn't really be folded in a separate closet. Now you need to review your selections. Check whatever aesthetic or color palette you were going for to your closet. That way you're able to make sure that everything matches up. You also want to make sure that you have some things for special occasions. Make sure that this piece of clothing is very versatile, that way you're able to wear it to all of these different functions. And you could dress it up or down depending on what it is. And add certain accessories or other pieces so that way you're able to make it seem like a completely different outfit. Then you want to organize your closet. Since everything's in a certain aesthetic and color palette, I don't really organize things that way. The way my closet is currently set up, it's sweatpants, jeans, dress pants, skirts, dresses, dress shirts, easy shirts, sweaters, and then jackets. Once again, you need to double check that everything belongs where it is. You want to make sure that you double check that everything belongs. This doesn't just apply for aesthetic and color, this also goes to check to make sure that what's in your closet didn't mean that be donated, and what's in your donate or giveaway pile is meant to be in your closet. And finally, you need to make sure that you keep it simple. You're gonna like it a lot more that way. Everything will look a lot more cohesive, and it'll save you time getting dressed in the morning. That's all! Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And ring the bell so you get every notification for my new videos. Thanks again for watching. Bye-bye!